this lecture, we are going to discuss about the classification of elementary particles by using the symmetry in quantum mechanics. First we discuss about the some symmetries in quantum mechanics. Let us consider first the permutation group. So what is a permutation group? Now let us consider n particles, n objects. So O1, O2, O3, up to OI. So you consider n objects. Now we define transposition. Transposition of O3 and O1 means. So O3, O1 means. So O1 goes to the position O3 and O3 goes to the position O. So that is the meaning. So after transposition, the arrangement is like this. O3, O2, O1 and O1. So transposition of O3 and O1 means you are changing the position of the objects. So O3, O1. So the arrangement is like this. Now let us first discuss the exchange operator. PIG operator. This we call as the exchange operator. The exchange of objects in boxes I and j. So PIG operator, this is the same as operator j and l. So I to j means j to l, so both are equal. So once if you find the square of PIJ square, so if you exchange it two times, you get the original one. So this is the identity operator. Now you consider objects, there are O1, O2, O3, ON in this order. And you operate P13 means you are exchanging 1 and 3. So finally you get a, and this is O3 and this is O1, position is exchanged. Now if you do this two times, this is the first time you are doing, the second time you are doing, your P12, two times you are doing. So this is an, if you do one time it is an odd operator, if you do this two times it is an even operator. Now here P14 acting on this one is the 4 goes to the position here and 3 goes to that first position. So during the first operator it becomes like this, and the operate P14, the object in the fourth position goes to the first position, object in the first position goes to the fourth position. So this is your final result. Now let us consider the permutation. So what is the permutation here? Now you can take 1, 2, 3, 4. You consider 2, 3, 4, 1. So you consider this is a permutation operator. So this is a power of rectangular matrix. Now it acts on alpha 1, beta 2, gamma 3, delta 4. Means, so what happens to this permutation operator? 1 goes to 2. So 1 goes to 2 means the object here, the alpha 1, this 1 goes to 2. So it becomes alpha 2. 2 goes to 3 means the beta 2 here, 2 goes to 3, so this becomes beta 3. 3 goes to 4, therefore here the 3 goes to 4, gamma 4, and 4 goes to 1, so this 1, the 4 goes to 1. So now when this permutation operator operating on this function, finally the function changes to alpha 2, beta 3, gamma 4, delta 1. So it can be rearranged like this, delta 1 and alpha 2, beta 3, gamma 4, delta, alpha, beta, gamma. So the permutation operator operating on alpha, beta, gamma, delta, then the function changes to delta, alpha, beta, gamma. So that is the meaning of the permutation. Now the permutation can be represented. So you consider this permutation can be represented by the product of three transpositions. So you take This is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now here you take this transposition operator. P14, P13 operator, transposition P12 operator. So P14 can be written like this. First you write down the 1, 2, 3, 4, and if you, 1 and 4, they are exchanged. So this is a transposition operator. So you get the 1 and 4. So the, this is exchanged. For P13, you write down P1, 2, 3, 4, their order, and 1 and 3 are exchanged. So here the 1 goes to 3, this position, and the 3 goes to the first position. So there is an exchange of these two numbers. Here also P12 means, so 1, 2, 3, 4 is the correct order. P12 means, and the 1 goes to this position, and these two goes to this position. So you write down this permutation like this. And if you want to operate the three operators, then you have to do this in this order. So you have to go from here. What is the meaning? 1 goes to 2. You take the first 2, this operator and this operator. So first, what happens on P13 operator and P12 operator? What is the net result? Let us find. So 1 goes to 2 and 2 goes to 2. So finally, the 1 goes to 2. So the 2 goes to 1 here, then 1 goes to 3, then finally it goes to 3. So 2 goes to 3. Similarly, 3 goes to 3 here, and 3 goes to 1 here. So finally 3 goes to 1. 4 goes to 4, and this 4 goes to 4. So, yeah. So P13 operator, P12 operator. So once if you perform this operation, you will get this result. Again, now let us do this operation again in this direction. 1 goes to 2, so 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 2. Therefore, this 1 goes to 2. 2 goes to 3, and 3 goes to 3, therefore you write on 3 here. 3 goes to 1, 1 goes to 4, you write 4 here. 4 goes to 4, and 4 goes to 1, so you write on this one. So finally you will get the result. 1, 2, 3, 4, in the upper row, the lower row, this is 2, 3, 4, 1. So if you perform the three operators, P14, P13, P12, you will finally get this. This is the result on permutation operator. Now, the state of the function can be represented. Suppose psi of alpha 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the state of the function. That can be expressed as the product of the four functions. Alpha of 1, beta 2, gamma 3, and delta 4. And this means psi of 2, 3, 4, 1. This means alpha 2, so that is the mean. Beta 3, gamma 4, and delta 1. So that order is right. So the first 2 comes here, 3 comes here, and so on. So this becomes, so if you arrange in the order, this becomes delta, alpha, beta, gamma. So this is the psi 1, 2, 3, 4 means alpha, beta, gamma, delta. Then psi of 2, 3, 4 means this is a delta, alpha, beta, gamma. So this is the meaning of this function. Now let us consider the permutation group S2. Here choose a two particle system. So there are two particles, psi of 1, comma 2. The numbers 1 and 2 comprise all coordinates, position, spin, and isospin of particles 1 and 2 respectively. So 1 means the position coordinate x1, y1, z1, and it also contains the spin quantum number as well as the isospin. Similarly, 2 means it includes everything, the position x2, y2, z2, spin, and isospin. we can build a symmetry and anti-symmetristic out of psi of 1 2. So psi of 1 2 is given. Let us construct a symmetry state as well as the anti-symmetric state. Symmetric state is may be expressed as like psi of 1 comma 2 plus psi of 2 comma 1. So this is symmetry. Anti-symmetric state is psi of 1 comma 2 minus psi of 2 comma 1. Here psi of 2 comma 1 means the permutation, the exchange operator p 1 2 operating on psi 1 2, it goes to 2 comma 1. Now this can be easily checked. So if you take a symmetry operator and we exchange the parting p 1 2, what happens? P 1 2 operating on psi of x, we have defined this form psi of 1 comma 2 plus psi of 2 comma 1. If you operate P12, so P12 operating on this one and P12 operating on psi of 2 comma 1. If this will exchange, so it gets, so after exchanging, and the function becomes psi of 2 comma 1, and this becomes psi of 1 comma 2. Finally, this result is a psi. So after exchanging the particle, function remains constant. So it is, so that's why this is called as symmetry state. Anti-symmetry state means if the exchange after making an exchange of the particles, so P12 operating on psi A, so psi 12 psi minus psi 21, these are psi A. So if you exchange the particles, so this becomes psi of 2 comma 1 and minus psi of 1 comma 2, this is minus psi of A. So if you exchange operator operating on a function, it gives a minus of the original function, then this function may be called as an anti-symmetric A. So therefore psi of A is anti-symmetric and psi of S is symmetric. Now the two particle states psi of S and the psi of A can be graphically represented in the form. Instead of writing instant the function, this is a graphical representation. So if you write down the if you draw your two square boxes in a row, particular row, this is symmetric. So this is a symmetry. So this is in the, if you arrange the boxes in a row, if you arrange the boxes in a column wise, then this is called the anti-symmetric. So anti-symmetric is represented by the boxes in a column wise, and symmetric state is represented by arranging the boxes in the row wise. So here each particle is associated with a box. Two boxes in one row describes a symmetric state. Two boxes in one column describes an anti-symmetric state. This representation of the symmetric states are called as Young diagram. So there is a meaning. So this is a diagram is called as a Young diagram, or may be called as a Young tablets also. So this may be Young diagrams or Young tablets. So there is only one Young diagram for one particular state. So for this two particular states, you are having two boxes or two states. For one particle state, there is a only one box. This is a Young diagram corresponding to one particle. This is a there are two boxes. This is the Young diagram corresponding to two particles. Now let us consider three particles. So one particle, one box. Two particles, two boxes. So they are arranged row wise as well as column wise. The another one, we consider three particles. If you consider three particles, the symmetric state may be expressed as by arranging the three boxes in a single row. For fully anti-symmetric, these three boxes can be arranged in a column wise. For a mixed state, so in addition to symmetric as well as an anti-symmetric, there is one more state called as mixed symmetry. And this mixed symmetry, the boxes are arranged in a row as well as the column. So the column wise, since there are three particles, there are three boxes. So two boxes here, and column is also this is a two boxes. So finally there are three boxes. So this is the way you have to arrange for mixed state. Now we arrange a identity operator, i.e. symmetrization operator and anti-symmetrization operator here. This is we are introducing a symmetric operator by this S, I, J, operator, say symmetric operator is equal to identity operator plus the exchange operator Qh. So this is the definition for the symmetrization operator. Now for anti-symmetrization operator, this is I minus Qh. So this is anti-symmetrization. Now let us find Sij, Aij. Let us find the two operators. So Sij, Aij, you write down the definition for the symmetrization operator, I plus Pij into I minus Pij. So once if you simplify, you will get a zero. Now, if we start with the state, psi 1, 2, 3, clearly the state of mixed symmetry reads us. So the mixed symmetry may be expressed in the form. Psi 1, this is one mixed symmetry, A 1, 3, S 1, 2 operator. Psi of 1 comma 2 comma 3, psi 2, so there are 4 states of possible, psi 1, psi 2, psi 3 and psi 4, that can be expressed in terms of the anti-symmetric and symmetrization operator. Now for an example, you consider psi 1 explicitly, you want to do it explicitly. Now when you write down psi 1 is equal to A 1 3 operator and the S12 operator, this one. So first you operate S1, the symmetrization operator on the function. So there is a A13, just you keep it like this. And this means, so by the, using the definition of the symmetrization operator, what is the first term? First term is the identity operator. So this is the first operator is the same value, psi of 1 comma 2 comma 3. Then you have to exchange this one. 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1. So this becomes 2 goes to 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1. So you will get this expression. Now let us use the anti-symmetrization. A 1 2 3. Now the first term is you use the same value, then you have to use the negative sign of this. Negative sign, and as well as you have to interchange the part 1 and 3. So if you interchange the first term 1 and 3, it becomes this is 3, 1, and this is minus of, if you exchange here, this is becomes 1 and 3. So this becomes 3 and this becomes. So by the definition of symmetrization operator, because symmetrization operator and the anti-symmetrization operator that we have here, I plus Pij operator and I minus Pij operator. So by using this one, by the definition, psi 1 can be arrived in this form. Similarly, psi S means what? Symmetrization operator. This is psi S. S 1, 2, 3 is the symmetrization operator. Symmetrization operator operating on psi of 1, comma 2, comma 3. Now, symmetrization operator that we have for the three particle system. For a three particle system, S123 operator. So this is the definition of the symmetrization operator. The symmetrization operator is I plus P1 exchange operator, P13 exchange operator, P23 exchange operator, P12, P13 operator, P13 operator, P12. So this is for this is the definition for the symmetrization operator for S123 acting on psi 1 2 3. So now let us do this one by one. When I operating on psi, you will get the first term as it is. So no change. P12 operating on this one, 1 and 2 are changing. So this will get this second term. P13 operating on psi 1, 2, 3. Here, we will get the third term. So 1 and 3 are exchanging. 1 and 3 are exchanging. Now, P23 again. 2 and 3 are changing. So you will get this term. Now you perform. So this P12 operator, P13 operator on this one. First you interchange 1 and 3. After that you have to interchange 1 and 2. You will get this thing. So the last term is P13 operator, P12 operator operating on psi 1, 2, 3. First you operate exchange operator, you have to use the exchange operator P12. So first 1, 2 is you have to change. After that you have to apply P13 operator, the 1, 3 must be changed, finally you will get this. So the psi s, the symmetry curve function may be expressed in terms of this one. So you have 6 terms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there are 6 terms. Now instead of writing all the 6 terms, you can simply write 3 boxes. 1, 2, 3, there are 3 boxes. The meaning of these 2 are both same. This is a symmetric, the symmetric function may be expressed in terms of your 3 boxes by using Young diagram. So by using Young diagrams, you can write up 3 boxes. The meaning is the same. Anti-symmetrization operator. Anti-symmetrization operator, so the wave function psi of A can be obtained by using A123. This is anti-symmetrization operator operating on psi 123. Anti-symmetrization operator is defined by this. This is A123, A12 operator, A13 operator, A23 operator. So this is the your anti-symmetrization operator. When it operates on psi 1, 2, 3, then this can be also expressed in this form also. I minus P12 minus P13. This is symmetrization. This and plus P12 P also. This is anti-symmetrization operator can be expressed in terms of the exchange operator, because we have already defined the definition for anti-symmetrization operator. By using the definition, you substitute for A12, A13, A23, and if you multiply, you will get this step, you will get this expression. Now, you operate this one on the psi 1, 2, 3. So, first term is, once if you operate a unit operator on psi 1, 2, 3, you will get the first term, and minus P12 operator on psi 1, 2, 3, you change it. 1 and 2, so we will get this expression, psi of 2, 1, 3, and P13 operating on psi 1, 2, 3, exchange of the particle between 2 and 3, you will get the third one. And the fourth one is, first you have to exchange P13 first, 1, 3 first, then after that you have to exchange 1 and 2, you will get that expression. Similarly, the last one, exchange operator P12 operating on psi 1, 2, 3, exchange between 1 and 2 first, then if you operate the exchange operator 1, 3, 1 and 3 must be interchanged. So this. So this is your anti-symmetric function. So the anti-symmetric function may be expressed in terms of the 3 boxes in the columns. So by using Young diagrams. So this representation is more convenient. So we will that will be discussed now. So instead of writing all the 6 terms, you can write 3 boxes in row-wise for symmetric wave function, and the 3 boxes can be written in terms of the column-wise if it is an anti-symmetric function. Then for a mixed symmetry, it is symmetric as well as anti-symmetric. So it's a mixed symmetry. This is defined by AIKA. Operator SIJ operator, this anti-symmetric operator and the symmetric operator operating on psi 1, 2, 3, where M runs from 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this can be expressed in terms of 3 boxes, the 2 boxes in the column wise, and here again this is a column wise and this is a row wise. So there are 3 boxes here. So this is 1, 2 and this is 3. So this is a representation of a mixed function. So the mixed wave function can be expressed in this form. This anti-symmetric wave function may be expressed in terms of three boxes in the column wise, and the symmetric wave function may be expressed in terms of three boxes in the row wise. So all the three boxes, this representation is called the Young diagrams. Now let us discuss the standard form of Young diagrams. So that is important. Standard form is important. So if you want to write down the, if you draw the diagram, the boxes, you have to follow certain conventions. So now let QJ denote the number of boxes in the jth row. So if we define, then QI must be greater than or equal to QI plus 1. So the number of boxes in ith row must be more or equal to Q of I plus 1, I plus 1 row. So for example here, you consider, let us consider these two rows. The first row contains Q1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 boxes. And the second, so this contains 8 boxes, Q1. And the second one is Q2. So according to your convention, Q1 must be greater than Q2. Q1. And the number of boxes in the row, the must be greater than the first row, must be greater than the number of boxes in the second row. So this I is equal to 1. If you put I is equal to 1, this is the number of boxes in the first row, which is 8. Number of boxes in the second row is 5. Similarly, if we choose on the second and third, so this is a Q, what is Q3? This is Q3. Q3 is only 2 boxes. This is 2 boxes. What is Q2? Q2 is 5 boxes. So the number of boxes in the second row must be greater than the number of boxes in the third row. If you consider a fourth one, again there are 2 boxes. So the number of boxes in third row and the fourth row are equal. So that is also allowed, because according to the convention, QI must be greater or equal to QI plus 1. So this is the way you have to draw the Young diagrams. Now here there are four. These four symmetric representation, this anti-symmetric function, this is a mixed symmetry, there are four, the 4 plus 1 plus 5. These six states form the basis of the irreducible representation of the permutation group. Here all the states and well-defined symmetry particles are called basis functions. So now, so far we have discussed about the how to draw the Young diagram. The Young diagram is more convenient than writing the in terms of the functions. And the, for drawing the Young representation, we have to follow the convention, and that must be important. The standard form of Young diagram is defined in the way that the boxes are labeled by positive integers, obeying the rules that the first row is the number in the one row of the diagram. Read from the left to right. Do not decrease. So that is important. Do not decrease. So you can write down the number, and number should not decrease. And the second rule is, those in the column, read from the top to bottom. So, row-wise, you have to read like this. You have to read like this. For column-wise, you have to read from top to bottom. that must increase steadily. So here number must increase steadily, whereas here number must be for if you write fill up, write down the numbers in the row, the numbers should not decrease. So for you consider three particles and let us consider four allowed states for one particle states. Now symmetry diagram is there are three particles, you have to draw three boxes and let us write down the states, four states, one particle states. Now first since there are three particles, you must have three boxes, so three boxes will be first, empty boxes, then you fill up the number, the numbers are the states. So if you write down one, the another may be one, because if you write down the numbers in one row of the diagram from left to right do not increase. So if it is one, and if you put one, that it is all right, because it is not decreasing, do not decrease. So again you can put one. So 1 1 1 is allowed. So this is allowed as per the rule. So again, what are the other states? 1 1, and the last one you can put two, because the number for first two boxes numbers are the same, they do not decrease, and the third one it increases from 1 to 2, it increases, so it is also acceptable. 1 1 3, the number 1 1 3, if you write down the number, it must increase or it should not decrease. That should not decrease, that is important. So 1 1 not decreasing, 1 3 is it is increasing, allowed. So 1 1 4, then you put 1 2 2. So you write down all the possible combination of the numbers. 1 2 2, all right. 1 2 3, all right, because the number increases steadily. 1 2 4, all right. 1 3 3, 1 3 4, 2 2 2, 2 2 3. So you fill up the numbers 1 to 4 within the box, so that the numbers should not decrease. 2 3 3, so the number is not decreasing. So you have to fill up the number from the left to right, and the numbers should not decrease. That is according to the first rule. So you can write all this. Now 1 2 1 is not allowed, because the first number is 1, second number is 2. Here the number 1 to 2, 1 2 is increasing, but if we put third number is 1, it decreasing. So it is not allowed as per the first rule. As per the first rule, the number should not decrease. So this is not allowed. And the second rule can be applied for writing the numbers in the columns. So this is consider a column, three boxes. There are three particles, so there are three boxes. There are four states. Write down all possible numbers within the box. So first 1 2 3, the number is increasing steadily. All right. So this is acceptable. 1 2 4, 1 2 4, again increases. So from top to bottom, the number must increase. 1 3 4, all right. 2 3 4, which is also correct. So this is also correct. But 2 4 3 is not allowed. If you take it here, the first number is 2, the second number is 4, last number is 3, 4 to 3 it is decreasing. So it is not allowed. So this is not allowed. 2 2 2, all numbers are same. Same number is not allowed. The number must increase. So it must increase. 1 2 3 or 1 2 4, 1 3 4. You put 2, the other number should not be less than 2. So it must be more than 2, must be 3. And the last one, it must be more than the previous one, 4. So it must so we have to follow the two rule. If you write down the numbers, if you want to fill up the numbers in the Young diagrams in the horizontal wise, the numbers should not decrease. If you fill up the numbers in the Young diagrams along the column wise, the numbers should increase. So using these two rules, you can fill up the numbers. For the mixed symmetry, there are three boxes. If you put one is allowed because the same number, it do not decrease. So one all right. Here column wise, if you put one, the number must increase. So this is, if you put one, this must be two. So this is a correct form. If you put 1, 2, all right, because 1, 2, it is increasing. The first, according to the first condition, the number should not decrease if you go from left to right. So 1, 2, all right. Here also 1, 2. Yes. So using the first rule, the number must increase along the row. Should not decrease along the row. It may be equal or it must increase. Along the column, the number must increase. So using the two rules, this mixed symmetry can be filled up. So this is called the mixed symmetry. So here, okay, now let us discuss about the connection between SU2 and S2. So the fundamental representation of special unitary group in two dimensions is spanned by the two vectors. One is a 1, 0 column vector, and psi 2 is a 0, 1 vector, and this vector is represented by state 1, and this is psi 2 is represented by a box written the number 2. So there are two states for the particle with the spin off. The Young diagram, this is your Young diagram, the square is the Young diagram, the box is the Young diagram. It symbolizes both members of the doublet. So there are doublets, so one state is possible, two states. So this is both members of the doublet. We know that both irreducible representations of the permutation group S2 and represented by the Young diagram, this is a symmetric representation. For anti-symmetric representation, this is the column wise, and then the numbers can be written like this. So 1, 1, because there are two states, 1, 1, for 2, 2 is also possible. Then so there is a possible third state. The third state is psi of 1, 1, psi 2 of 2, here psi 1 of 2 and psi 2 of 1. So this can be simple, write down like this, two boxes, write down 1, 2, so the increasing order we can write. So this is another a possible state. So now so there are three different configurations. One is 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2. So previously we have written within the square, this is 1, 1, and 2, 2, and 1. So the Young diagram represents the different standard configurations. The corresponding multiples have three dimensions. If you proceed with the anti-symmetric representation of S2, there is only one possibility to construct the anti-symmetric state. So here psi will be psi 1 of 1, psi 2 of 2 minus psi 1 of 2, psi 2 of 1. This is represented by the Young tablet by 1, 2. So you write on the column vector, column boxes. So there are two boxes in the column wise. If you put number 1 here, it must be 2. 2, 1 is not allowed. 1, 1 or 2, 2 is not allowed. The number should increase. So it must increase from 1 to 2. So here there are three representations. Whereas here this for anti-symmetric representation is only 1. Thus the related irreducible representation is a singlet. in order to classify the connection, the connection between SU2 and S2, we normalize the wave function represented by linked tablets. So single representation, because this is single representation, psi 1 2, this is actually psi of 1, so psi of 1, psi of 2 minus psi of 2, psi of 1, 1 by root of this is the normalized wave function. So this is a single representation, is represented by 1, 2 in the column wise for the unsymmetric wave function. For a symmetric function, there are three things. 1, 1, which is psi of 1, psi of 1. 2, 2 means say up to say up to this 1, 2 boxes, so 1 in the first box and 2 is the second box, 1 by root of say up 1 say up 2 plus say up 2 say up 1. So this forms a triplet. So there is a singlet and there is a triplet. These are exactly the possible states which results from the coupling of two spin half particles to spin 0 and spin 1. And when J1 is equal to half, J2 is equal to half, J value runs from J plus J1 plus J2 to J1 minus J2. So this is, there are for half of particles the capital J value is 0 and 1. So when J is equal to 0, M is 0. So this is capital J is equal to 0, M magnetic 1, this is a 0. So this is 0, 0 state is a single state. And for 1, this is a 1, 1, 1, 1, this is a spin up, spin up, 1 minus 1, spin down, spin down, 1, 0, 1 by root of spin up, spin down, plus spin down, spin up. So this is a triplet state. Now let us go for the discussion of SU3 generally, because this is much more important for our discussion. This is useful for discussing the elementary particles. So in order to discuss or classify the elementary particles, this SU3 symmetry is much more important. Now here, let us write down the generators of this SU3 group. These generators are given by lambda 1 vector. This is one generator, this is represented by the 3 by 3 matrix 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Similarly, lambda 2 vector in this form, lambda 2 vector 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. This is a third vector. Similarly, fourth vector, lambda 5, fifth operator, sixth one. So, sixth, seventh, and there are 8 generators. So, these 8 generators are the generators of SU3 group. For Pauli's spin matrix, sigmas are the generators for writing the SU2 group. So if you write down the generators for SU2 group, we have to write down the Pauli's matrices, 2 by 2 matrices. For SU3 group, the generators are, there are 8 generators. This is a actually, these generators can be derived by from the Pauli's matrices. So if you write down the Pauli's, suppose 0, 1, 1, 0 is a Pauli's matrix. If you take lambda 1, if you 0, 1, 1, 0, if you take this 2 by 2 matrix alone, it will be your sigma 1 matrix. And once if you move this 1, 2 along this direction, 1, here, from here to here, and here to here, you will get the lambda 4. So you get a lambda 4. So similarly, Pauli's matrices, you take the second Pauli's matrices, 0 minus I 0. Similarly, if you move, you will get the other generators. So from the all these matrices you can write down the generators for issue 3. So lambda 1 to lambda 8, there are 8 generators there are 8 generators for issue 3 group. So now let us write down all the 8 generators, and now let us redefine the generators as by the symbol fi operator is equal to half lambda I. So now let us redefine. According to the definition, you write down fi operator comma fg operator, and this is the commutation relation. The commutation relation between the two f operators is defined by I times fijk fk. So this is I is root of minus 1, and this ijk is the index. So this fj ijk are called the structure constants. This I is root of minus 1, you must remember. So this is called as the structure constants. The commutation relation between the generators is called as the Lie algebra. The Lie algebra for the SU3 symmetry. So this is the Lie algebra for the SU3 symmetry. Now, if we define the various operators by T plus or minus operator is equal to F1 operator plus or minus F2 operator, T3 operator is equal to F3 operator, D plus minus operator is equal to F4 operator plus or minus F5 operator, Y operator is equal to 2 by root 3 F8 operator, U plus or minus operator is equal to F6 operator plus or minus I F7. So we define a different types of operators, T, V, U, as well as T3 and F. Now one can construct commutation relation for the new operators. Among these, you choose a T3 operator. T3 operator is what? F3 operator. What is F3? You put here, F5 operator is equal to half times lambda 3. So if you put I is equal to 3, it is F3. So F3 is equal to half times lambda 3. What is lambda 3? Lambda 3 is a 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, 0. So it is a, this matrix is a diagonal matrix. So lambda 3 operator is a diagonal matrix. Similarly, if you take Y operator, Y operator is equal to root by 3, F8 operator. If you put F8 operator, F8 operator is related to lambda 8 operator. Lambda 8 operator is a diagonal matrix. So lambda 3 and lambda 8 are diagonal. That is important. So among all the 8 matrices, you see lambda 3 and lambda 8 are diagonal. Since they are diagonal, it will commute. Diagonal matrix will commute. So you take this Y operator and the T3 operator, both are diagonal form. So you write down the two Y operator and the T3 operator, it will commute, so it will be 0. So if an operator commutes, then Y and T3 may have simultaneously diagonalized. Any two operator commutes, it will be simultaneously diagonalized. We may denote the common set of eigenstates. So both Y and T3 will have the same eigenstate because it will commute. So two operator commutes, then both these operator must have the common eigenstate. So if you define, this is a cut symbol. This is the cut of symbol T3 Y. We call this is a eigenstate. This is the eigenstate for T3 operator, as well as this is the eigenstate for Y operator. So that is because both are commutes. So since the two operators commutes, it will have a common eigenstate. So T3 Y is the common eigenstate. So if T3, now let us take T3 operator operating on T3 Y. So this is the cut. So this is the operator operating on the cut state. You will get T3 Y3 because it is, since it is a this is a diagonal matrix, you can we operate on the eigenstate, you get an eigenvalue, some eigenvalue T3 times the same state. So this is a eigenstate and this is a eigenvalue. For if you take a y operator also, and since both are having the same eigenstate, and the y operator operating on the same eigenstate t3y, you will get some eigenvalue, some constant times t3y, and the some that constant we call as y. So the t3 operator operating on the eigenstate gets the eigenvalue t3, and y operator operating on the eigenstate will get the eigenvalue 1. And both y and t3 are having the same operator because they commute each other. This will commute each other because they are diagonal matrix. Now we consider the three states in the SU3 symmetry. So first state is because this is three dimension, special unit group in three dimension. So first state is a column vector 100, you are represented by a box of the number 1, and the second state Q2 is represented by a column of vector 010, and which is represented by a box with number 2, and the third state is represented by 001, which is we can write down a box with the number 3. So box with number 1, 2, 3 are three different states in the SU3 symmetry. Now you take the T3 operator operating on the eigenstate. So if you are operating on the eigenstates, what is the value? If it is an eigenstate, then you will get the some constant times the same state. So you take a T3 operator, by the T3 is related by lambda 3. Lambda 3 is available. So first write down the lambda 3 matrices here. You just refer back in the previous page. So this is your lambda 3, 1, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, 0. And your F3 is the half times lambda 3. So by using this one, you can write down this. Half times this matrices. And the first state is, Q1 state is 1, 0, 0. And if you make a matrix multiplication, it becomes half times 0, 0. So this is half times the same state, 100 is the same state. So T3 operating on Q1 gives half times the same state. So there is an eigenvalue equation. So half is called as the eigenvalue. So half is the eigenvalue if the T3 operating on the state 1. Similarly, if we take a T3 operator operating on the state 2, state 2 is what? 0, 1, 0. You know the T3 matrix, you substitute 0, 1, 0 is the column vector, and operating this one, you will get the eigenvalue is minus half times Q2. Similarly, when T3 operating on the third state, you will get the 0 eigenvalue. So these are the three eigenvalues. So T3 operator operating on the state 1, 2, 3. Similarly, you take the Y operator. Both Y operator and T3 operator will have the common set of eigenstates. So if you Y operate on Q1, it gives you know the what is y? Y is 2 by root 3 times f8, where f8 is equal to half times lambda 8, and lambda 8 is equal to 1 by root 3 of this matrix. So you have to use this one, and you have to use this one, and you have to use this one. So if you use all the three and you substitute here y, so 2 by root 3, 1 by 2, 1 by root 3, and this matrix operating on the state 1, 1, 0, 0. Then once we make a multiplication, we will finally get 1 by 3 times Q. So Y operating on Q1 gives 1 by 3 of Q1. So this is an eigenvalue equation, 1 by 3 is the eigenvalue. Similarly, Y operating on Q2 gives 1 by 3 times Q3. Y operating on Q3 will get a minus 2 by 3 times Q3. So you get the eigenvalues. So you write down the eigenvalues here. So T3 comma Y within the bracket, you write the eigenvalues, and the first one, if you T3 operating on state 1, you will get the eigenvalues half that we have already discussed. This is the value. And Y operating on 1, you will know 1 by 3. So this is half. And this is 1 by 3. And you write down this eigenvalue within the box, we call this is a weight. So for the state, and this we call this a weight. If we substitute for the two, second state, P3 operating on this state 2, well, the eigenvalue is minus half, and this is a y operating on 2 gets 1 by 3. Similarly, P3 operating on state 3, you get 0, and this is a, so this is a weight corresponding to the each state, state 1, 2, 3. Now draw this diagram, P3 along the x axis and y along the y axis, and you will get this one. For the first state is here, and this is half and 1 by 3, and here second state, this is minus half 1 by 3, and third state is 0. So draw this weight diagram. So this weight diagram will be useful for further discussions. Since the weights behave as additive numbers, the weight of many particle states are obtained by summing up the components. We'll discuss how to add the weights. Suppose if you consider an example, consider a mixed state 1, 1, 2. So you consider this mixed state. The weight is P3 is equal to for this state 1. The weight is half. For the state, this one also you have half. For the state 2, this minus half. So if you add this one, half plus half minus half, which is equal to half. So this is a T3. The weight corresponding to this mixed state is like this, half. If you similarly, if you want to find y for the first state is 1 by 3, y for the another first state is 1 by 3. Y for the second state is also 1 by 3. So if you add, you will get 1. So T3y is equal to half comma 1. So this is the way you have to find out the total weight of corresponding to the mixed state 1, 1, 2. So multiples of SU3 constructed from these particles. So now let us construct the SU3. Now, we get the following N diagram, because there are three particles, so three boxes. One is row wise, so it's one diagram, and mixed state, there are three boxes are arranged in this form, figure 2. Figure 3 is three states, three boxes are arranged in the column wise. Now let us fill up the numbers. If you write down the numbers 1, 2, 3, suppose we take the third diagram. Figure 3. If you put number 1, the next one is number 2, the number next one is number 3. So this must be only in the increasing order. So this is the only possible way, because there are three states and three boxes. So you have only one possible way. So it represents the singlet, because there is only one function is allowed. Suppose we consider a second diagram. For second diagram, so this is a mixed state. We put one here, and you can put another one here, and two here. So the number do not decrease, here the number must increase. So this is an allowed state. So what is the weight corresponding to this one? If you want to calculate the weight, find the T3 corresponding to the first box, find T3 corresponding to the second box, find T3 corresponding to the third box. So you add the three values, you will get half. And similarly, y value corresponds to all the three bags if you add to this. Because for the first box, T3 y values are given here. For second box, the T3 values are given here. Third box, the T3 y, the weight diagram is given here. This is the weight corresponding to T3 y for all the three particles are available. Now, by using this, you can calculate the weight corresponding to all the boxes. So what are the other possible states? 1, 1, 3 possible states, 2, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3, 3, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 3. So these are the possible values of red sticks. So you cannot write like this. If you, the first number is 3, so you cannot write 3, 2, 1, because this number is decreasing, not permitted. Also the number is decreasing, not permitted. So this is so these are the only 8 possible ways of writing these sticks using our definition discussed earlier. So this one for the diagram 3, you have one state. For the figure, so second diagram, you have 8 states. Then for the first diagram, so this is 111, 222, 333, then 112, 122, 113, 133, 123, 223, 233. So these are the 10 possible states you can write. You can write on the weight corresponding to all the states. So here this is your T3 value and this is Y value. So T3 corresponding to 1, first one state. T3 corresponding to the second one, second state, and the first state. T3 corresponding to the third box. This is also 1. So for example, if you consider 2 to 3, suppose for example, you will take this one. 2 to 3. If you take 2 to 3, here this is we have shown here. T3 corresponding to the first, this box is minus half. T3 corresponding to this is also this is minus half. And T3 corresponding to the third one is 0. Because once if I add this, it will be minus 1. Similarly, Y corresponding to the 2 is 1 by 3. Y corresponding to the second 2 is 1 by 3. Y corresponding to the third street is minus 2 by 3. Once you have, you will get a 0. So T3 comma Y is minus 1. Zero. So that is it. So by using this, you can add the T3 values and add the Y values. You can get the corresponding weights and you can write down these weight values within the box T3 Y. Now, so here, now let us draw the plot T3 versus Y. So this T3 versus Y for these boxes. For example, say 111, this state, T3 value is 3 by 2, 1. So here, this is a 3 by 2 value, and this is a 1 value, so this is. So this point corresponds to the horizontal 111. Similarly, you take 222, minus 3 by 2, 1. So this is this direction, this is minus 3 by 2, 1. So this is your 222. So 111, 222, take 333, 02. So this is the point. So similarly, all the 10 points can be filled. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 0, 0 is also there. 1, 2, 3, 0, 0. So here it is. So all these points can be drawn in a diagram. So this is a decouplet. This is a decoupler. Similarly, for the diagram, we will discuss the quark state later. Now you see just the boxes, Young diagram boxes alone, 111, 222, 133, etc. First you will draw this in terms of the Young diagram boxes. Now similarly, for the this is for the first diagram. For the so for the mixed state, the third diagram. So for the mixed state, here you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and if you draw these values here, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, etc. So using the Venn diagrams, you can draw the diagram. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, there are here, there are 2 points, 8. So this is 8 points. So this is a actor, and this is a 10 points, this is a decoupling. So using the symmetry, we fix the points in the T3Y diagram. This is for a mixed state and this is for a symmetric state. For anti-symmetric state, there is only one particle. Now, this is the first state and the second state and third state. So if you want to study the elementary particles, and this is a quark particles. Quark is a combination of the particle is a combination of three quarks. There are one quark is upward, another down, and another one is strange. So there are three quarks. So the combination of three quarks gives an elementary particle. For the meson, it is a quark antiquark. For other particles such as baryons, you have a three quark combination. So the first state is represented by up state, second state is represented by D, and if you write on the third state is represented by S. Then you replace 1, 1, 1 by U, U, U. So up, up, up. This here 2, 2, 2 is down, 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 D, D, D. And here 3, 3 is yes, yes, yes. Similarly, for any other thing, suppose 2, 2, 3. So here 2, 2, 3 is what? Down, down, yes. So this point, these boxes can be replaced by U, 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 D, U, D, 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 and so on. Similarly, for mixed symmetry also, all this, so this box is 1, 1, 2. There is a up, up, down. This is for a mixed symmetry. In the after stage, this 1, 1, 2, this mixed symmetry can be replaced by the combination of quarks U, U, D here. And 1, 2, 2 is what? Up, down, down. So up, down, down. So all the boxes can be replaced by the car and the combination of three quarks for both after symmetry and decoupled symmetry. Now let us discuss the elementary particles, and we will match this the theory with our symmetry group. The elementary particles. So the elementary particles can be categorized into two ways. One is a lepton and hadrons, depending on what the interacting type. If it is a weakly interacting particle, we call this leptons. Strongly interacting particles are called hadrons. So hadrons are strongly interacting and leptons. And lepton particles are this electron and the neutrino associated with the electron, muon associated with the, and the neutrino associated with the muon, and tau particles associated with the mu neutrino. Mu tau. So the charges are negative. Electron E minus B minus tau minus, so the charge is negative. For antinode, the charge is 0. For hadron particles can be classified into two groups. One is a meson, that's a spin 0 particle. And the other one is a baryon, which is having spin half as well as spin 3 by 2. So depending on the spin, it can be differentiated. But baryons are the combination of three quarks, a three quark system. For mesons, it is a combination of quark and antiquark, Q, Q bar. Now, a Q quark triplet, there are up, down, strange. So there are combination of these three. Now, from the I3 diagram, I3Y diagram that we already discussed, for I3 for upstate, is half 4 by 3, because this diagram we have already established. This diagram we have already discussed. So this is stated, this is half and this is 1 by 3. So half 1 by 3 is I3Y and minus half 1 by 3 is for downstate and 0 minus 2 by 3 is for strain state. Now the you can fill up the diagram, fill the numbers within the table. Now this I3 is actually the third component of the isospin quantum number, and Y is your hyper charge. Now you write down the charge Q, baryon number, isospin number, third component of the isospin, and the strangeness number, and Y. The Y is equal to B plus S. Now this is Y and I3 that you have already calculated. So you can fill up this value. Y value is 1 by 3, 1 by 3, minus 2 by 3. This is I3 is equal to half, minus half, 0. You can fill these numbers first. Then this is a baryon. Baryon, what is, there are three quarks makes one baryon. So one quark is equal to 1 by 3 baryon. Therefore, the baryon number is 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 3. And the charge is equal to Q is equal to I3 plus B plus S by 2. So you know B values and you know I3 values. Yes. Also, the charge, what are the charges of the different quarks? The charge for the three quarks are, for the up quark, this is 2 by 3 values of the electronic charge, and D is minus 1 by 3 G, and S is equal to minus 1 by 3. So, you write down this 2 by 3, minus 1 by 3, 1 by 3, and if we substitute this expression, you can find the strangeness value. Q value is available for example, if you consider a square, for a square, Q value is minus 1 by 3, I3 is a 0 value, and baryon number is 1 by 3, if you substitute S is equal to minus 1. So this is equal to S is equal to minus 1. So if you consider D value, S value is 0, and U value is 0. So all these are the remaining values can be filled for a quark triplet. Now let us take a spin half baryon. For spin half baryons, what are the group? There are 8 particles. We already discussed. The first, you write down the I3Y values, because this we have already calculated. I3Y, this is for 111, like that. So for quark quantum, 1, 2, 2. Because we have already calculated these values, is equal to half 1. So for all the other values, you can write down half, minus half 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, half, minus 1. So you first fill up these values, I3, comma Y value. Weight value is here. Now, from the states, so from your previous diagram, so what is the diagram is? Diagram figure 2. So from figure 2, yes, from figure 2, you know this is the quark content is UUD. So you write down the quark content here, because it is given as 1, 1, 2. So this is given in the figure 2. This is given in the figure 2. So you refer the figure, your previous diagram. It is 1, 1, 2 corresponds to T3, I3. The T3, I3 are the same, third quantum number. So you write down I3 and Y here within the bracket, and this corresponds to UUD. So for other I3, Y values, you write down UDD and so on. So you first fill this number, you write down the quark card and the other number. Then, what is the, since it is a baryon, the baryon number is 1. So you write down the baryon number is here. And the T3 values and Y values can be written here. So this is I3 values can be written down from here. white file is coming around here. Then UUD, what is the charge? This charge for U is 2/3, and the charge for another U is 2/3, and the D is half. So for UUD, Q is equal to, for UUD, this is 2/3 plus 2/3 minus 1/3, which is equal. The charge is what? So you write down the charges. So for each quark content, the charge number can be filled up. So the charge number can be filled up, this can be filled up, Y can be filled up, I3 can be filled up, and S can be determined from this expression. Y is equal to B plus S. So from this, S can be also filled. And here, the charge plus 1 and the spin, isospin, third compound of isospin half, and the which is called as a proton. The particle proton is having a charge plus 1, positive charge plus 1, a spin is half, and a charge 0 is neutron, which is also having a spin minus half. So this forms a subgroup, PN, nucleon, and having the same isospin number. I is equal to half, I3 will third quad number. Okay, I is equal to half, I3 varies from plus half to minus half. So this is half and this is minus half. So this can be filled up. If it is 0, 0, the charge must be UDS. This combination is UDS. If you call the charge 0, so this is 0, variant number 1. If it is 0, the particle must have 0 charge, so you put 0 here. This particle is called as a lambda particle. And for UUS, the charge is plus, so you form this group. Here the spin is 1. Since the spin, third quad number, the spin of the third quad number, the projection of the isospin, which is I3. If I3 is 1, then it will not, it should not be a proton, because for proton it is half. So if it is though Q is plus 1, if I3 is 1, so it must be a forms a different group. So this is a 1, 0, minus 1, the I3. You group this one, and this is a sigma particle, sigma plus, sigma 0, sigma minus. So this can be grouped. This is similarly here. The charge is 0, here this is minus 1, this is a strangeness number is minus 2. So using this expression, you can find the strangeness number. The strangeness number is minus 2. For a proton and neutron, this is strangeness is 0. For other particles are a strange number, there is a strangeness number, we have strange particles. So here the number is minus 2. So this can be grouped in psi particle. This is a psi particle. Sometimes it may be called as a cascade particle. And this is sigma particle. Lambda 0. They are called as a hyperon. Then this is for a very this is spin half system. A spin 3/2 system. You can have four groups like this. And delta particles, omega, psi particle, this omega is, yes, similarly, you can find the I3 Y values, and from I3 Y values, you can write, or you can fill up this bracket, right, for each particle, corresponding, you can write on the quark content. You write down first here, write down the quark content, then write P3Y and write down the quark content. So you follow the first, fill up this one, and then fill up this one. You write down P3, the I3 here, and Y here. P3, I3 having the same value. So here, this is P3, and this is your I. Then, using this expression, the charge can be, so using UUD is, what is the charge? 2 by 3 plus 2 by 3 plus 2 by 3, which is equal to 2, so QI. So then QI can be entered, since they are variance, B can be entered. So you can group this one, I3 plus 3 by 2, half, minus half, minus 3 by 2. So you group this one, and these particles are called as delta particles. Since the charge is 2, so you put this is delta plus plus, and this is delta plus, and delta 0, delta minus. This is forms a small group, and this sigma plus star, sigma 0 star, sigma minus star, this forms another group. And this is psi particles, and sigma 0, psi 0, psi minus 1, and omega minus 1. So these are hyperons. So these numbers, so here there are 10 numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and so this is a decoupler. So for S3 by 2, spins S3 by 2, you have a decoupled system. The sigma part, delta particles, sigma particles, and psi particles, and omega minus omega particles. Then, the meson is a QIQJ bar, the quark antiquark system. For quark UDS, QJ, this is U bar, B bar, S bar. The, what are the constants? U bar, U D bar, U S bar, U. So you take this U bar, U D bar, U S bar, D U bar, D D bar, D S S bar. So these are the different possible constants. So what is the quantum number corresponding to the anti-quark system? U bar, D bar, S bar. You write down the quantum numbers corresponding to the quark system. And just you put reverse all the signs. So the charge is plus 2 by 3, the charge here is minus 2 by 3 for U bar. Here the charge for D is minus 1 by 3, for the quark, for anti quark is minus plus 1 by 3. Similarly, so you change the sign of all the quantum numbers except I. So except I, you change the all the quantum numbers with a negative sign. So that is the quantum numbers corresponding to the anti-quark system. So for U bar, so we have already discussed this one, I3Y, we have already calculated. So we have 8 particles. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Actually, there are 9 particles you can get. So this is only you group like this. This is 8 particles will be put in a group, because this is an octet, because SU3 is an octet. So this is a meson particles. Again, you can easily find the charges for each system. You, the charge for UD bar is, U is 2 by 3, D bar is here plus 1 by 3. Which is equal to 1. So there is two. So there is a. So this is a baryon number is 0, because this is the meson. Baryon number is 0, and the charge can be determined by using this method. You know I3Y that we already calculated by using the symmetry ideas. So the remaining numbers, quantum numbers can be calculated by using the relevant formula. So you fill all the numbers. So here there will be 8 particles. 1, 2, yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This belongs to the pi meson, pi plus 0 minus, and this is a k on, k plus k 0, and this is a k minus k 0 minus, and eta 0. So this is 8 particles. In addition, you have one more state, which is a singlet, because we have already discussed. One decoupler for S3 by 2, and one octet for spin half system, And for spin zero systems, you have a octet. Octet along with, if you include this singlet also here, you may call this as a nonet, and you call this as eta prime. If you don't include this one, this will be acted, and this singlet must be an anti-symmetric state. That must be expressed separately. So, many elementary particles were experimentally observed. Earlier to SU3 method, but before the discovery of the this symmetry method, many elementary particles were experimentally observed. But this eta zero meson and omega minus hyperon were experimentally found only after the prediction of SU3 approach. So SU3 approach says there must be a particle of N0 particle and omega particle. This is a theoretical prediction, but experimentally it was not observed so far. But lately they found that they have observed the experimental epsilon eta 0 meson and omega minus hyperons were experimentally found only after the prediction. So it validates the success of the SU3 classification. So it predicts that there must be a particle of this type, N0 meson and 10 meson must be present. Though it was experimentally not observed so far, but the theory says that there must be a particle of this form, N0 meson, omega 0 meson. But later on, after a few years of SU3 method, they experimentally it was observed in eta 0 meson or omega 0 hyperon from experimentally found. So it validates the success of SU3 classification. So according to SU3 symmetry particle, we have three identical particles. So three quark system here and three states, up, down, three strange, there are three states. So this is a one box, second box, third box corresponds to three boxes, and each box you have three states. It can have three states, this can have three states, and this can have three states. And this cross within the circle is called a direct product. And what is the direct product of all these three? That can be obtained using any diagrams. You take first any two, these two alone. So take a cross, direct product of two groups. Two boxes, this is equal to two boxes here, horizontal row wise plus column wise. So this once if we take two boxes, and if we take three boxes and find a direct product, and you take this and you make a direct product with one box, so this is a separately written two boxes cross product and direct product with the one box plus this is a direct sum. This is the anti-symmetric state there. This is with this one. And once we simplify this one, you have three along horizontal direction, and there is a mixed one. That is the only possible way. Here, mixed one plus three. So there are this is three. We have already found that this corresponds to a T couple. We have already discussed for baryon spin 3 plus spin. Baryon is a T couple state. And this is an octet state for baryon that we have already discussed. And this is the octet for meson. And the one particle, eta prime, is a symmetry. So finally, you have this is a decoupled is a 10, and this is a 8, and this is also 8, and this is plus 1. So 10 plus 8 plus 8 plus 1, 27. Three direct products, 27. So this 27 is split into these groups. One belongs to decoupler, another one is octet, another one is octet, and another is a single. So accordingly, this is the symmetry model. So this classification of the elementary particles, they are beautifully explained by the symmetries.